okay. You know it. If you've watched the show, you know it.
You are not.
1, 2, 3 o'clock, 4 o'clock, rock. 5, 6, 7 o'clock, 8 o'clock, rock. 9, 10, 11 o'clock, 12 o'clock, rock. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. Put your glad rags on. Join me, hon. We'll have some fun when the clock strikes one. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock, gonna rock around the clock tonight. When the clock strikes 2, 3, and 4, if the band slows down, we'll yell for more. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight. We're gonna rock, rock, rock till broad daylight. We're gonna rock around the clock tonight.
Everyone, this is Missy.
Boo.
Now, Missy met her husband, Freddie, when she was just 17 years old. And Missy says,
baby, baby.
Freddie is the most loving, attentive husband and father she could ever ask for. But Missy says that while Freddie has been the perfect husband, she has been far from the perfect wife. Because she's been keeping some terrible secrets from Freddie that threatened to turn his world upside down. Now, let me give you a hint at what the secret is that Missy is about to reveal. This is Missy's husband, right, Freddie? Here are Missy's two children.
Damn sure ain't his kids. You better carry your big ass somewhere else.
What's your secret?
I cheated on my husband with two different men.
They must have been drunk as fuck, because ain't no way. Ain't no way.
Neither one.
And there's a good chance that neither one of my kids belong to him.
Now, I have to ask you. You and your husband have been together for some time.
Yes.
He's a good father to these kids.
Yes.
He takes care of these kids.
Yes.
And he thinks these kids are his.
He need brain surgery or something, because them damn sure ain't his kids, old nerdy looking bastard.
This is what he had to say before the show. Watch.
Missy and I have been married for 5 years. We have two great, adorable children together. I'd do anything for my children. I work hard to provide for them. My family is my life. To be honest, I'm angry with Missy because she's keeping a secret from me. Our marriage is supposed to be based on trust and honesty. And I feel that she has broken that trust and honesty because she has kept the secret from me. Missy, you know I love you. We've been through a lot together. And I hope the secret that you're about to tell me today does not destroy everything that I'm working towards with you.
Missy, he seems like a great guy.
Actually, this is what he really is.
Freddie, my audience loves you already, and they don't even know you. All they do is know about you. And here's what they know about you. You're a good husband. You're a great dad. Now, tell us about your relationship with Missy.
I was sitting at home one day, and my pager went off. And I called her back, and that's how it pretty much started. Her and I, we just started talking from there.
Right.
And then that's when I realized that this is the girl I wanted to be with.
So, Missy, turn to Freddie. Tell him why you brought him all this way.
I want you to know that I love you a lot.
I love you a lot.
Listen.
And that you mean everything to me. And I know that I haven't been the best wife. I know that I get distant sometimes and I don't appreciate you and things like that. And since we moved to a different state to start over with everything, I had to tell you something before you decide if you want to stay with me for the rest of your life. And what I have to tell you is that I cheated on you with two different people.
And tell them everything.
And that there's a chance that Kaden and Kayla aren't yours.
I love my kids to death. and do whatever I can.
Not your kids, fam. Even Stevie Wonder can see that shit.
That there's a possibility.
Damn, ain't your kids, Sam.
24 hours ago, I heard a secret from Missy. Yes, I'm still a little devastated by it, but no matter what those test results say tomorrow, Michaela and Caden will always be my children.
Are you gonna tell me right now that you still believe what you said on that tape?
Yes, I do.
That no matter what I read in terms of these results, those are gonna be
they're gonna be my children.
You're gonna be their daddy forever.
Forever.
We're gonna have lots of kids, and we're gonna name them all after you. Even the girls. That way when you come to visit us, there's gonna
wake up!
No matter what.
Freddie, in the case of 3-year-old Michaela, you are not. Missy. You can't think it. Missy, you. Okay? You wanted to do this. Come on. Man out there, you better be with your man. If you walk and leave your man, you know what can start happening. You better console him. Don't think of yourself here. Think of him.
Don't touch me. Don't touch me.
Don't fucking touch me! Don't fucking touch me!
In the case of 1-year-old Caden, Freddie, you are not. Freddie.
I gotta fucking come home! Phyllis! I should fucking kill you!
I know you have a lot to think about. I know you hope to the but you said something to me and to everyone that when you look at your children, you see your children.
Yes.
You don't see color.
I know that you're gonna be those children's father, no matter what. I have a feeling it's going to be more difficult for you to deal with Missy than it is to deal with those children.
It's not the kid's fault.
You know that. Okay. You're a very good man. You're a very good man. Everyone, this is Sylvia. Sylvia is 13 years old.
Wow. Boy, that's crazy.
So at 12, when most girls are playing with dolls still, Sylvia found herself in a very adult situation by being pregnant. And now she has a 2-month-old son, Raul. Now, as you can imagine, this is some difficult time for young Sylvia at 13. But what makes this even harder is that Sylvia does not know who her son's father is. It could be one of 2 teen boys. Either a 15-year-old named Justin or his 16-year-old best friend, Gerard. We're gonna meet both of them in a moment, but first take a look at this 13-year-old mother's story.
My name is Sylvia and I got pregnant at 12 years old. I'm 13 years old and I have a 2-month-old baby. I'm so young, I wasn't supposed to have a kid. And it's so hard being a kid and having a kid. I should have listened to my mom when she told me not to have sex. I don't know who my baby's father is. I didn't have a father growing up, and I want my baby to have one. It's between 2 guys, 15-year-old Justin and 16-year-old Gerard. I gave up everything, my school, my friends. I cry all the time, and I can't take this. I want it to be Justin's because I know he'll care about my baby and he'll love him. But I don't want it to be Gerard's because I know he won't love it at all. Gerard will be a bad dad and I don't want him to be the father. I love my baby to death, but I'm so young and I just wish I never had sex.
Before we meet 15-year-old Justin and 16-year-old Gerard, who, by the way, just to underscore this, they are best friends. Listen to what the idea of being a teenage father is doing to these two kids.
My name is Gerard. I'm 16 years old, and Sylvia brought me here for a paternity test.
My name is Justin. I'm 15 years old, and Sylvia brought me here to see if I was the father of her baby.
I really don't know if I'm the father of Sylvia's baby. Truth is, I only had sex with Sylvia a couple of times, and I used protection.
I really don't know if I'm the father, but part of me says that I want to be, but part of me says that I don't.
I seen a picture of the baby from my friend Justin. I don't think the baby looks like me at all.
Sylvia told me that the baby was 3 weeks earlier than what it was supposed to be. So now I'm thinking that it could be somebody else's other than me and Gerard's.
I heard Sylvia slept around. I just came here for an answer. I just wanted to know if the baby's mine. I'm not really scared or nervous. I was at first until I seen a picture that Justin showed me. And I really think Sylvia's lying. I don't think the baby's mine.
I'm an AB student and I'm playing football and I want to be a football player and go to the Marines, but if I'm a father at 15, that could slow me down on everything.
I don't want this child to be mine. I'm only 16 years old. I want to do something with my life.
Neither one of you look happy, right? It's not a good situation to be in. How'd you feel that when you found out, Gerard, you could be the father?
I was scared at first, and then I found out that Justin could have been a father also. Right. And then when he showed me the picture, it looked nothing like me.
How about you, Justin? You didn't find out till the baby was born, right?
Yes, sir.
What do you think?
I didn't think it was mine because she had always said that it was Gerard and Gerard, but then after the baby was born, she just said, all of a sudden, she said it was me.
Right. Gerard, were you all boyfriend, girlfriend?
No, we weren't.
Don't you lie.
Were
you boyfriend and girlfriend? Yeah, we were. Don't lie.
You was with you gonna tell me how it was mine.
Who the hell is I don't know who
it is either. You tell me.
Shall we find out right now? I mean, I'll tell you something. I feel sad. I feel sad for every single person in the story. When it comes to 2-month-old Raul, Justin, you are not the father. When it comes to 2-month-old Raul, Gerard, you are the father. Sylvia. 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 I know you don't want it to be this way. Okay? But at least you know who the father is. You knew it could be one of the two. Now, you all have a child together, and you all are going to have to come to some kind of an agreement because you don't want that child to see two parents who are at each other's throats. You know that, don't you?
Okay. I'm going to take care of my child, though, no matter what.
Well, good. Be a stand-up guy. Thank you very much. Okay, Sylvia? Is your father your child? Okay.
What's up, man? What's up, man?
Everyone, this is Nick. Nick is deeply in love with his wife, Crystal. But this love comes at a tremendous price and a lot of pain. Because in the beginning of their relationship, Crystal leaves Nick for a man named Eric. And then right about the time of the breakup, she gets pregnant. And since then, Nick and Crystal get back together again and, by the way, are now married. But neither Nick nor Crystal is sure if Nick or Eric is the father of their son, Layton. And this is what it's doing to Nick. Watch.
When it comes to Layton, it really does feel like I was betrayed. There's another man on my son's birth certificate when I'm his father, and he don't do nothing for that child. That's not his daddy. I'm his daddy no matter what. The DNA test says I'm his father, and I'll always be there for him.
Always be there for him.
I've never felt nothing like that before when I, you know, first got to be with my child. Never experienced nothing like that before. And then it's all taken away from me for a whole year. I never seen him, you know, I didn't change his diaper or nothing. proving that he's my child would be the best thing that's ever happened to me, just for him to, you know, blood, to know that he is my kid, you know?
And so she gets pregnant.
She got pregnant with me. And
she doesn't know who the father is, but she even wants him to be the father. And so that child lives with the two of them for how long?
A whole year.
And did you see that child?
Maybe twice.
Yeah. Do you know this guy?
I never met him, but I know of him.
Right. All right, everybody, here's Crystal. Crystal, come on out.
Oh, Crystal Meth.
Welcome. Crystal, it's amazing. Don't you, you want this child to be Nick's, don't you?
Yeah, I want him to be Nick's. That's his child regardless.
Whose name's on the birth certificate?
He put his name on a birth certificate as the father of the child. He's not the father. That dude ain't no father. That dude ain't no man. That dude ain't no but a punk bitch.
Straight up. I'll tell
you a punk. Come out here and we'll handle it, partner.
Before we meet Eric, this is what he had to say.
I'm 100% sure I'm not the father of this child. This baby looks nothing like me. Crystal, you're nothing but a gold digger. Crystal, your husband ain't nothing but a little bitch. Can't stand Crystal's husband, Nick. I like to whip his ass. The only time Crystal calls me when she's having problems with her husband. I'm not no kickback. When DNA proves I'm not the father, they better lose my number.
All right, I don't want anything f***ing. I'm gonna tell Eric the same thing. Here's Eric. Eric, come on out.
You ain't no but a punk, bro. You ain't no but a
you see it, bro.
Hey. Stop it. Why don't you think you're the father?
He looks not like me. I want it to be. Man, they have that. They have that.
Oh, my kid. Bitch.
Did I say it?
Oh, my kid.
Did I say it?
Eric.
Yo.
Huh? What happened?
I lost my job, and she ran back to this school.
We're gonna find out right now. When it comes to three-year-old Leighton, Eric, you are not the father.
Yeah.
Bye.
Catch you later, and that be all.
Yeah. When it comes to three-year-old Leighton, Nick, you are the father.
Yeah. Yeah, where's he at? Where's he at, Mom?
Where's Leighton?
Come here, boy. Where's
your daddy?
Who's your daddy?
Who's your daddy?
Yeah.
Okay, now let's try to be a family.
The way you always wanted to be, right?
Everyone, this is Tiffany. Welcome, Tiffany, to the show.
Boo.
This is Tiffany's mother, Anne. Welcome, Anne, to the show. Both women say that a man named Anthony is making
five
their lives
chance
a living hell.
Looking ass boy.
Tiffany says from the moment she gave birth to her daughter, Mia, Anthony has completely denied her. Anthony insists Tiffany slept with his friend, Sean, and his other friend, Dustin. Around the same time she got pregnant. Tiffany and Ann say it's a complete lie. Yeah. And we'll prove that Anthony's the dad. Watch.
The first time I met Anthony, I thought we were gonna be together. But now I realize he is nothing but a devil. I delivered my daughter Mia and she had the same eyes Anthony did. But when I reached out to him, he didn't want nothing to do with us. Now he's trying to say my baby belongs to his friends Dustin and Sean, and I don't even know those clowns.
Anthony's poor excuse for a man.
Shut the fuck
hey,
up!
Hey.
I'm the one who dropped my daughter off when her and Anthony had sex. My daughter wouldn't lie to me.
My daughter wouldn't lie to me.
I know Anthony is Mia's father. I've met every guy that my daughter has slept with.
Your ass slept with him too.
Go, never heard of him.
Anthony's trying to push this responsibility on someone else. This is the last time he'll deny my baby.
Anne, who's helping to raise this child?
Me and my husband are.
By the way, I am glad to see finally a grandfather of a child show up. Sonny, your husband. Nice to see you, Sonny. Who do you think? What do you have to say about this, Sonny?
I just think he's a trash bag. He needs a step up. Nigga, who the hell is you?
We was nice to you. You don't even work. You do nothing. I take
care
of
everything. Listen.
I take care of my kids.
Man, I don't care what you talking about. You talking about you working, you do all that. Bro, I met you.
You do nothing.
I met you over Facebook, and you said
you want
to play. You want to play beer pong.
You hit me up on Facebook.
You wanted to play beer pong.
And I'm a hoe. I'm a hoe.
Smack you. Get you out of here. Get you out of here. Okay, let's talk about that. Let's bring that up. Let's bring that up.
Anthony, what happened five days ago?
What happened 5 days ago? What you wanna?
What's that?
Pull this out one time, man.
Go ahead.
What happened?
Yep.
Put her out there.
Yeah, put me
I had your daughter 4 days ago. I just found out I was pregnant. You just found out you was pregnant.
It wasn't
but
bad.
You had the baby
she
4 days ago.
She just had the baby.
Whatever, that's how it's written on here. But this is what I'm saying. You saying I'm a trash bag father and all that.
You're not a father
at all.
You might feel that way.
But I'm saying,
you're not a dad. You don't know what it is like to be a parent.
If you was for sure, man, I ain't hearing none of that. Like I said,
you don't know what it's like.
Man, you know what you be doing.
I don't remember asking you a goddamn thing.
This is what I gotta say, though.
Yes.
This is what I gotta say, though.
Go ahead.
What type of female, you feel me, find out she pregnant and know for sure that I'm the dad and don't contact me? How can I be a trash bag?
And I said all I wanted to do was get the DNA.
You contact me after you had a baby, like, oh, I just had your daughter 4 days ago.
Anthony, you look like that child.
You didn't pay attention to her.
I don't look like that baby. You look like that baby. That baby is yours.
This is what these two guys have to say.
Tiffany is the biggest hoe I ever met. We met Tiffany at the bar, and a few hours later, she had her legs open.
All she needed is a drink, and she messing with you on the same night. We was having sex with her a few times that night.
Tiffany's like the mailman. She's at everybody's house. The sad part is, she tried to say we never had sex with her, and we both know that's a damn lie.
You need to be exposed. That girl was a whore. I don't got no reason to lie, neither.
And as for Tiffany's daughter, that baby looks nothing like me. I'm just here to clear my name.
I ain't the father of Tiffany's baby. If you ask me, it looked like Dustin.
She says she doesn't even know you two.
No,
you
are there. I don't know you, and she I don't know you.
That's right. She's not neither one of you.
Now you don't remember, huh?
Maury, you got the trash bag. Now you got the trash to go in the trash.
There you go.
Let's get to the DNA. Anthony, you're the father you'll be in this child's life.
Man, most definitely, man.
When it comes to 2-week-old Mia, Anthony, you are not the father.